Good afternoon and welcome. My name is Kevin Quinn. I'm the Vice President for University Advancement at Immaculata. And having started less than a month ago, this is a wonderful thing to be able to do as one of my first official duties. Usually you have to do all the hard work up front to put a name on a building. I just get to show up for the naming, so that's wonderful. Sister Pat, the members of the board, the sisters, student leadership, administration, admission staff, financial aid staff, alumni, parents, friends, this is truly an extraordinary day. Welcome to all of you, and to our folks who are going to be viewing this online eventually, so welcome to them. This is a special ceremony dedicating this brand new campus landmark. And even though I've been here less than a month, I found Immaculata to be overwhelmingly welcoming. And this building reflects that. It's our natural way of welcoming people now to this campus, prospective students and their families, and even current students as they come in to work through financial aid issues or anything. This is a place that sends a very different message about what that experience should be like. From the lighthouse cupola to the wraparound porch throughout the design, everyone who enters here is embraced by Immaculata. Of course, all of this architecture and construction wouldn't mean much if it wasn't for the outstanding staff that is here. So I just want to make sure we acknowledge the admissions and financial aid staffs who are housed here in the building. I want to thank that staff for welcoming us into their home this afternoon. And without any further ado, I'd like to introduce our president, Sister Pat Fatten.
Thank you, Kevin, and welcome to all of you. Thank you for the support, friendship, and dedication, especially for joining us here for this celebration. Immaculata is really blessed to have you here. Some special thanks are due to those who have helped to make the vision of this new admissions and financial aid center a reality. Although not all are able to be here, I want to take this opportunity to recognize publicly the Immaculata University Planned Giving Committee, Mary Queen Miller, Quinn Miller, class of 1946, former trustee Joseph Wisinich and his wife Catherine, Mary Beth South Spimmerly, class of 1986, current trustee Marian Hammocky Romeo, class of 1967, and her husband Bob, and the estate of Virginia McNabb, who is the sister of retired faculty member Sister Virginia Dolores IHM. Eventually, many spaces within this building will have markers acknowledging their leadership roles in the creation of this wonderful facility. And if you would like to know what they are, you'll see them all lined up behind me, awaiting the sign. So you can read those at your leisure. But today we gather formally to announce the new name of the Admissions and Financial Aid Center. From this point forward, this building will be known as the Lillian P. Lettiere Center, named in memory of the mother of Barbara Lettiere and her brother Jack, a proud alumna of the class of 1972 and a current member of the Immaculata Board of Trustees. Barbara's gift is an exceptional public display of her confidence in Immaculata. While she was making this important decision, it was uppermost in her mind the impact this gift would make on Immaculata for years to come. She has shared her hopes with us that this gift will inspire others to join her in supporting our university in a personal and meaningful way. Both in her service as an Immaculata trustee and as the Vice President for Finance at Trinity University in Washington, D.C., Barbara has a clear understanding of the impact of philanthropy on small private institutions. She knows from personal experience that her gift will resonate for years to come, and she looks to all of us to share that message with other friends of Immaculata. Barbara, if you please join me. Thank you so much for your belief in your alma mater expressed in this exceptionally generous gift. And then I couldn't resist adding this as the toast. an Irish blessing. May love and laughter light your days and warm your heart and home. May good and faithful friends be yours wherever you may roam. May peace and plenty bless your world with joy that long endures. May all life's passing seasons bring the best to you and yours. May God reward your generous heart and hold you all your days in the palm of his hand. Thank you. I'm looking at all these very nicely prepared remarks and kind of screwed up. I was avoiding having to do this. This is quite overwhelming. But I would like to thank Sister Pat and thank all of you for coming here today. I especially want to thank my brother Jack for making the trip here. I haven't seen him in a few years, and this has been a wonderful reunion. I told him I was going to brag on him a little bit, so don't get mad at me. But I'm very proud of my brother. He didn't go to Immaculata. He did attend the General Motors Institute and worked his way literally from the bottom up at the New Jersey Department of Transportation. And his last job there was the commissioner for the state of New Jersey's Department of Transportation. So we're very proud of him. He, along with myself, do not know how to retire. He's retired from there, but he's still working. So I understand, Jack. It must be in the genes. Well, this new building is certainly a very special place. And I'm especially pleased to have a very special lady's name associated with it. Lillian Lettiere is my mom, and she played an extremely important role in my life, as did Immaculata. Indulge me for just a few seconds here to relate a story about my mom's influence in my decision to come to Immaculata. So you know how it is when you're a junior, senior in high school, you're going around looking at different colleges. And Jack and I knew that not going to college was not an option. Education was extremely important to my family, even though Jack and I were the first ones in our little family to be able to attend college. So after looking at a few colleges, my mom made her decision very clear where I was going. And when I asked her, "Mom, what do you think?" "Well, Barbara, I like Immaculata." "Well, Mom, you gotta tell me why." "Well, it's close to home, and we can come and see you. Or if you get homesick, you can come home." I said, "Geez, Mom, is that it?" She said, "No, no." She said, "I looked everywhere around that building. I couldn't find a speck of dirt." Jack, really? You can't make this stuff up. So, with some teaching assistantship that Immaculata was very gracious in awarding me, the decision was really easy. And so my decision was to come to Immaculata. This building was built, as was mentioned here today, was built as a welcoming and effective way to attract new students. And I can't think of a better ambassador for this purpose than my mom. She loved Immaculata. And I am sure that she will do her best to live up to her top billing. So Mom, you never had the opportunity to go to college, but you have arrived. Faculty that are here, administrative staff, and any students who may be here, on behalf of my family, we wish you continued success and hope that this building
will be a very important part of that success. Thank you all very much.
I don't have nearly anything as eloquent to say as what you just said. Barbara, thank you very much. I'm going to ask Father Christopher Rogers to come forward to say a prayer, and that will be followed by the singing of the Alma Mater that will conclude our program. And when our program concludes, you will see that there is enough dessert here to feed this entire campus, so we're going to have to handle the chore. So please enjoy each other's company and the desserts and time together at the conclusion of the program. There's actually some coffee and beverages and water in the little area behind us here. So after the program, please feel free to linger and enjoy each other's company.
I'm honored to be here today. I think today is a fitting day for this dedication and this naming, fitting not just because your family is here with us and all the board and so many family of Immaculata, but fitting too on this National Patriot Day when we remember the importance of names. Today, throughout our country, the naming of all those who have lost their lives 11 years ago today, those names are so very important, etched in stone in so many places. The names of this day are important. It's also fitting because tomorrow we celebrate a name day. Tomorrow is the feast of the most holy name of Mary. We celebrated her birthday on Saturday. Tomorrow we'll celebrate her naming. And so as we gather in this building today, which now bears a name, we dedicate it. It's been through many stages. There was a blessing of the ground when the ground was broken. There was a blessing on opening day. Sister Ann Heath and I were talking about this. Today, a blessing for its dedication, a reminder that each step along the way of this building, each stage, God's presence has been invoked upon it. And today marks another stage similar to our lives. So let us not only pray for this dedication as we honor the name it now bears, but also pray for our university and for each individual life that will come here to Immaculata. Each one bears a name, and each one is worthy of God's grace. Each one is loved by God. Let us pray. God, our Father, we praise you and thank you for your many gifts, the gift of your friendship, the life through whom we become your sons and daughters, called by name. We thank you for the many signs you give to us of your love, for the generosity found in good people, and for the ability to be co-partners with you in your work of creation. Father, as we dedicate this new admissions and financial aid center here today, we ask your blessing on the family name it now bears. May this name forever be a sign to us of the generosity you call us to in the service of one another. May it spur us on to bear your name and your mission well, to the praise of your glory and for the benefit of all. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.